This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Coordinates: 50 degrees 6 minutes 50 seconds north, 8 degrees 40 minutes 7 seconds east, 5,011,389 degrees north, 866,861 degrees east, 5,011,389, 866,861. Deutsche Bank AG, Deutsche Bank Twin Towers, the headquarters of Deutsche Bank in Frankfurt, Germany. Type: Aktiengesellschaft traded. Paul Achleitner, Chairman. John Cryan, CEO. Products: consumer banking, corporate banking, finance and insurance, investment banking, mortgage loans, private banking, private equity, savings, securities, asset management, wealth management, credit cards. Revenue: €3,353. Subsidiaries: Deutsche Bank Italy. Website: www.db.com. Deutsche Bank AG, literally German bank, pronounced DT, back AGE. Fourth quarter of 2013. This came after analysts had predicted a profit of nearly €600 million. According to FactSet estimates, revenues slipped by 16% versus the prior year on 7 June 2015. The then co-CEOs, Jürgen Fitschen and Anshu Jain, both offered their resignations to the bank's supervisory board, which were accepted. Anshu Jain's resignation took effect on 30 June 2015, but he provided consultancy to the bank until January 2016. Jürgen Fitschen temporarily continued as joint CEO until 19 May 2016. The appointment of John Cryan as joint CEO was announced. Effective 1 July 2016, he became sole CEO at the end of Jürgen Fitschen's term in January 2016. Deutsche Bank pre-announced a 2015 loss before income taxes of approximately €61 billion and a net loss of approximately €67 billion following this announcement. A bank analyst at Citi declared, "We believe a capital increase now looks inevitable and see an equity shortfall of up to €7 billion, on the basis that Deutsche may be forced to book another €3 billion to €4 billion of litigation charges in 2016. Contents: 1 History 11-1870-1919-111. Founding members: 112 first directors. 12-1919-1933-13-1933-1945-14. Post World War II. 15 since 2000. 151 housing credit bubble and CDO market. 152 leveraged super senior trades. 153 European financial crisis. 154 consolidation. 2 performance. 21 awards and recognition. 3 management structure. 31 the management bodies of Deutsche Bank. 311 management board. 312 Supervisory Board. 313 Group Executive Committee. GEC 4 Business Divisions. 41 Corporate. 4111 Markets. 4112 Corporate Finance. 412 Global Transaction Banking. 413 Asset. 9 See also. 10 References. 11 External links. History. Deutsche Bank, Sydney 1870-1919. Deutsche Bank was founded in Berlin in 1870 as a specialist bank for foreign trade. The bank's statute was adopted on 22 January 1870, and on 10 March 1870 the Prussian government granted it a banking license. The statute laid great stress on foreign business. The object of the company is to transact banking business of all kinds, in particular to promote and facilitate trade relations between Germany, other European countries and overseas markets. 3 of the founders were Georg Siemens, whose father's cousin had founded Siemens & Halske, Adelbert Delbruck and L. Bamberger. Previous to the founding of Deutsche Bank, German importers and exporters were dependent upon English and French banking institutions in the world markets, a serious handicap in that German bills were almost unknown in international commerce, generally disliked and subject to a higher rate of discount than English or French bills. Founding members: Hermann Zwicker Bankhaus GEBR Schickler, Berlin. Anton Adelson Bankhaus Adelson. Major projects in the early years of the bank included the Northern Pacific Railroad in the U.S. and the Baghdad Railway 1888 in Germany. The bank was instrumental in the financing of bond offerings of steel company Krupp 1879 and introduced the chemical company Bayer to the Berlin stock market. The second half of the 1890s saw the beginning of a new period of expansion at Deutsche Bank. The bank formed alliances with large regional banks, giving itself an entree into Germany's main industrial regions. Joint ventures were symptomatic emblematic of the concentration then underway in the German banking industry for Deutsche Bank. Domestic branches of its own were still something of a rarity at the time. The Frankfurt branch dated from 1886 and the Munich branch from 1892, while further branches were established in Dresden and Leipzig in 1901. In addition, the bank rapidly perceived the value of specialist institutions for the promotion of foreign business. Gentle pressure from the foreign ministry played a part in the establishment of Deutsche Überseeische Bank in 1886 and the stake taken in the newly established Deutsche Asiatische Bank 3 years later, but the success of those companies in showed that their existence made sound commercial sense. 1919-1933. The immediate post-war period was a time of liquidations, having already lost most of its foreign assets. Deutsche Bank was obliged to sell other holdings. A great deal of energy went into shoring up what had been achieved, but there was new business, too, some of which was to have an impact for a long time to come. The bank played a significant role in the establishment of the film production company, UFA, and the merger of Daimler and Benz. The bank merged with other local banks in 1929 to create Deutsche Bank und Diskontogesellschaft, at that point the biggest ever merger in German banking history. Increasing costs were one reason for the merger. Another was the trend towards concentration throughout the industry in the 1920s. The merger came at just the right time to help counteract the emerging world economic and banking crisis. In 1937, the company name changed back to Deutsche Bank. The crisis was, in terms of its political impact, the most disastrous economic event of the century. The shortage of liquidity that paralyzed the banks was fueled by a combination of short-term foreign debt and borrowers no longer able to pay their debts, while the inflexibility of the state exacerbated the situation for German banks. The crisis in the industry was a watershed, a return to circumstances that might in some ways have been considered reminiscent of the Golden Age before World War I was ruled out for many years. 1933-1945. After Adolf Hitler came to power, instituting the Third Reich, Deutsche Bank dismissed its three Jewish board members in 1933. In subsequent years, Deutsche Bank took part in the Aryanization of Jewish-owned businesses. According to its own historians, the bank was involved in 363 such confiscations. By November 1938, during the war, Deutsche Bank incorporated other banks that fell into German hands during the occupation of Eastern Europe. Deutsche Bank provided banking facilities for the Gestapo and loaned the funds used to build the Auschwitz camp and the nearby IG Farben facilities during World War II, Deutsche Bank became responsible for managing the Bohemian Union Bank in Prague, with branches in the Protectorate and in Slovakia, the Bankverein in Yugoslavia, which has now been divided into two financial corporations, one in Serbia and one in Croatia, the Albert de Berry Bank in Amsterdam, the National Bank of Greece in Athens, the Kreditanstalt Bankverein in Austria and Hungary, the Deutsch-Bulgarische Kreditbank in Bulgaria, and Banca Comercială Română, the Romanian Commercial Bank in Bucharest. It also maintained a branch in Istanbul, Turkey in 1999. Deutsche Bank confirmed officially that it had been involved in Auschwitz in December 1999. Deutsche, along with other major German companies, contributed to a $52 United States. Post-World War II. Following Germany's defeat in World War II, the Allied authorities, in 1948, ordered Deutsche Bank's breakup into 10 regional banks. These 10 regional banks were later consolidated into three major banks in 1952, Norddeutsche Bank AG, Süddeutsche Bank AG, and Rheinisch-Westfälische Bank AG in 1957. These three banks merged to form Deutsche Bank AG with its headquarters in Frankfurt in 1959. The bank entered retail banking by introducing small personal loans. In the 1970s, the bank pushed ahead with international expansion, opening new offices in new locations, such as Milan 1977, Moscow, London, Paris and Tokyo in the 1980s. This continued when the bank paid $603 United States. Deutsche continued to build up its presence in Italy with the acquisition in 1993 of Banca Popolare di Lecco from Banca Popolare di Novara for about $476 United States. Original developer defaulted on its borrowings. Deutsche Bank opened the casino in 2010 and ran it at a loss until its sale in May 2014. The bank's exposure at the time of sale was more than $4 billion. However, it sold the property to Blackstone Group for $173 billion. Housing credit bubble and CDO market. Internal email from 2005 describing Deutsche CDO traders' view of the bubble. Deutsche Bank was one of the major drivers of the collateralized debt obligation CDO market. market during the housing credit bubble from 2004 to 2008, creating about $32 billion worth. The 2011 U.S. Senate Permanent Select Committee on Investigations report on Wall Street and the financial crisis analyzed Deutsche Bank as a case study of investment banking involvement in the mortgage bubble, CDO market, credit crunch, and recession. It concluded that even as the market was collapsing in 2007, and its top global CDO trader was deriding the CDO market and betting against some of the mortgage bonds in its CDOs, Deutsche Bank continued to churn out bad CDO products to investors. The report focused on one CDO, Gemstone 7, made largely of mortgages from Long Beach, Fremont, and New Century, all notorious subprime lenders. Deutsche Bank put risky assets into the CDO, like ACE2006-HE1M10, which its own traders thought was a bad bond. It also put in some mortgage bonds that its own mortgage department had created but couldn't sell. From the DBALT 2006 series, the CDO was then aggressively marketed as a good product, with most of it being described as having a level ratings. By 2009, the entire CDO was almost worthless, and the investors, including Deutsche Bank itself, had lost most of their money. Greg Lippmann, head of global CDO trading, was betting against the CDO market, with approval of management, even as Deutsche was continuing to churn out product. He was a large character in Michael Lewis' book The Big Short, which detailed his efforts to find shorts to buy credit default swaps for the construction of synthetic CDOs. He was one of the first traders to foresee the bubble in the CDO market, as well as the tremendous potential that CDs offered in this, as portrayed in The Big Short. Lippmann, in the middle of the CDO and MBS frenzy, was orchestrating presentations to investors, demonstrating his bearish view of the market, offering them the idea to start buying CDs, especially to AIG, in order to profit from the forthcoming collapse. As regards the Gemstone 7 deal, even as Deutsche was creating and selling it to investors, Lippmann emailed colleagues that it blew, and he called parts of it crap and pig, and advised some of his clients to bet against the mortgage securities. It was made of Lippmann called the CDO market a Ponzi scheme, but also tried to conceal some of his views from certain other parties because the bank was trying to sell the products he was calling crap. Lippmann's group made money off of these bets, even as Deutsche overall lost money on the CDO market. Deutsche was also involved with Magnetar Capital in creating its first Orion CDO. Deutsche had its own group of bad CDOs called Start. It worked with Elliott Advisors on one of them. Elliott bet against the CDO even as Deutsche sold parts of the CDO to investors as good investments. Deutsche also worked with John Paulson, of the Goldman Sachs Abacus CDO controversy, to create some Start CDOs. Deutsche lost money on Start, as it did on Gemstone. On the 3rd of January 2014, it was reported that Deutsche Bank would settle a lawsuit brought by U.S. shareholders, who had accused the bank of bundling and selling bad real estate loans before the 2008 downturn. This settlement came subsequent, and in addition to Deutsche's $193 billion settlement with the U.S. Housing Finance Agency over similar litigation related to the sale of mortgage-backed securities to Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac leveraged super senior trades, former employees including Eric Ben Artsy and Matthew Simpson have claimed that during the crisis Deutsche failed to recognize up to $12 billion of paper losses on their $130 billion portfolio of leveraged super senior trades. Although the bank rejects the claims, a company document of May 2009 described the trades as the largest risk in the trading book, and the whistleblowers allege that had the bank accounted properly for its positions, its capital would have fallen to the extent that it might have needed a government bailout. One of them claims that if Lehman Brothers didn't have to mark its books for 6 months, it might still be in business, and if Deutsche had marked its books it might have been in the same position as Lehman. Deutsche had become the biggest operator in this market, which were a form of credit derivative designed to behave like the most senior tranche of a CDO. Deutsche bought insurance against default by blue-chip companies from investors, mostly Canadian pension funds, who received a stream of insurance premiums as income in return for posting a small amount of collateral. The bank then sold protection to U.S. investors via the CDX credit index. The spread between the two was tiny but was worth $270 million over the 7 years of the trade. It was considered very unlikely that many blue chips would have problems at the same time, so Deutsche required collateral of just 10% of the contract value. The risk of Deutsche taking large losses if the collateral was wiped out in a crisis was called the gap option. Ben Artsy claims that after modeling came up with economically unfeasible results, Deutsche accounted for the gap option first with a simple 15% haircut on the trades described as inadequate inadequate by another employee in 2006 and then in 2008 by a $1-2 billion reserve for the credit correlation desk designed to cover all risks, not just the gap option. In October 2008 they stopped modeling the gap option and just bought S. Suggested that the gap option was worth about 8% of the value of the trades, worth $104 billion. Simpson claims that traders were not simply understating the gap option but actively mismarking the value of their trades. European Financial Crisis Main Article, European Sovereign Debt Crisis. Deutsche Bank has a negligible exposure to Greece, Spain and Italy, however account for a tenth of its European private and corporate banking business. According to the bank's own statistics, the credit risks in these countries are about 18 billion euros Italy and 12 billion euros Spain for the 2008 financial year. Deutsche Bank reported its first annual loss in 5 decades, despite receiving billions of dollars from its insurance arrangements with AIG, including US$118 million. Above the 1,225% required by regulators as of March 2016, it stands at 111%, and it may be down to close to 105% by the time Deutsche Bank next reports first quarter 2016 earnings. Consolidation due to Deutsche Bank capital ratio Tier 1 CET1 is only 114% or lower than median of CET1 ratio of Europe's 24 biggest publicly traded banks with 12%, so there will be no dividend for 2015. In 2016. Furthermore, the bank cuts 15,000 jobs. Performance year 2014, 2013, 2012, 2011, 2010, 2009, 2008, 2007, 2006, 2005. 2004, 2003 net income 17 billion euros, euro 07 bn, euro 03 bn 43 billion euros, 23 billion euros, 50 billion euros, euro minus 39 bn, 65 billion euros, 61 billion euros, 35 billion euros, 25 billion euros, 14 billion euros revenues, 319 billion euros, 319 billion euros. 337 billion euros, 332 billion euros, 286 billion euros, 280 billion euros, 135 billion euros, 307 billion euros, 285 billion euros, 256 billion euros, 219 billion euros, 213 billion euros. Return on equity 51%, 26%, 5%, 18%, minus 29%. 30%, 26%, 16%, 1%, 7%. Dividend 075, 075, 075, 05, 45, 40, 25, 17, 15. Awards and recognition. The bank has been widely recognized for its transformation over the 10 years between 2002 until 2012 for moving from a German-centric organization that was renowned for its retail and commercial presence to a global investment bank that is less reliant on its traditional markets for its profitability. Deutsche Bank was named International Financing Review's Bank of the Year twice in a 3-year period, in 2003 and 2005. It also won the prize in 2010 and 2012, for the second time in 3 years. Deutsche Bank was named Best Global Investment Bank in the annual Euromoney Awards for Excellence in December 2012. International Financing Review IFR recognized Deutsche Bank as its Equity House of the Year and Bond House of the Year 2012. This is the first time the bank has been named Equity House of the Year and the 6th time that it has won the Top Bond Award. Deutsche Bank is also the only European bank to have been awarded the Top Equity and Bond Awards in the same year, highlighting the bank's success in equities. IFR said, Deutsche led major IPOs, took on tough risk positions especially in Europe and became one of the preferred banks of the U.S. Treasury. IFR also praised the bank's fortitude and skill in bond markets, saying it combined a steady hand with solid execution to get all kinds of deals done in just about every corner of the globe. Deutsche Bank won a further 7 IFR awards. Commodity Derivatives House EMEA Structured Equity House EMEA Loan House EMEA High Yield Bond House EMEA Liability Management House SSAR Bond House Sterling Bond House. In 2016, Standard Ethics AI assigned a rating to Deutsche Bank in order to include it in its Standard Ethics German Index Management Structure. When Deutsche Bank was first organized in 1870, there was no CEO. Instead, the board was represented by a Speaker of the Board. Beginning in February 2012, the bank has been led by 2 co-CEOs, and in July 2015 it announced it will be led by 1 CEO from 2016. The management bodies of Deutsche Bank: Annual General Meeting, Management Board, Supervisory Board, Group Executive Committee. Management Board. Management Board members as of 12 February 2016, John Cryan, Chairman and Chief Executive Officer, sole CEO effective 20 May 2016, Jürgen Fitschen, Co-Chairman, outgoing departed 19 May 2016, Stuart Lewis, Chief Risk Officer, Sylvie Matheret, Chief Regulatory Officer, Quinton Price, Head of Deutsche Asset Management, Garth Ritchie, Head of Global Markets, Karl von Rohr, Chief Administrative Officer, Dr. Markus Schenk, Chief Financial Officer, Christian Sewing, Head of Private Wealth Staff Council, Member of the Group Staff Council, Carl Gerhard Eich, Management Consultant, KGE Asset Management. Marlene Thiem, Director, Infrastructure, Regional Management, Communications, Corporate Citizenship. Tilman Todenhofer, Managing Partner, Robert Bosch Industrie. Treuhand KG. Klaus Rudiger Truscheler, previously Member of the Management Board of Franz Haniel. By the Management Board Committee members as of 1 January 2013, Jürgen Fitschen, Co-Chairman. Anshu Jain, Co-Chairman. Stefan Krause, Chief Financial Officer. Stefan Leithner, Chief Executive Officer, Europe except Germany and UK, Human Resources, Legal. Christian Ricken, Chief Operating Officer, Private. Corporate Finance. The Corporate Finance Division is responsible for advisory, debt and equity issuances and mergers. Banking activities for private clients and small and medium-sized businesses. Citation needed. Private Wealth Management. Private Wealth Management functions as the bank's private banking arm, serving high-net-worth individuals and families worldwide. The division has a strong presence in the world's private banking hotspots, including Switzerland, Luxembourg, the Channel Islands, the Caymans and Dubai. Communication. In 1972, the bank created the world-known blue logo, slash in a square, designed by Anton Stinkowski and intended to represent growth within a risk-controlled framework. Controversies. Deutsche Bank in general, as well as specific employees, have frequently figured in controversies and allegations of deceitful behavior or illegal transactions. As of 2016, the bank was involved in some 7,800 legal disputes and calculated 54 billion euros as litigation reserves, with a further 22 billion euros held against other contingent liabilities. Tax evasion. Six former employees were accused of being involved in a major tax fraud deal with CO2 emission certificates, and most of them were subsequently convicted. It was estimated that the sum of money in the tax evasion scandal might have been as high as 850 million euros. Deutsche Bank itself was not convicted due to an absence of corporate liability laws in Germany. Espionage scandal. From as late as 2001 to at least 2007, the bank engaged in covert espionage on its critics. The bank has admitted to episodes of spying in 2001 and 2007 directed by its corporate security department, although characterizing them as isolated. According to the Wall Street Journal's Page One report, Deutsche Bank had prepared a list of names of 20 people who it wished investigated for criticism of the bank, including Michael Bohndorf, an activist investor in the bank, and Leo Kirk, a former media executive in litigation with bank. Also targeted was the Munich law firm of Bub Gauweiler. Expect the appropriate authorities, including state prosecutors and the bank's oversight agencies, will conduct a full investigation. In May 2009, Deutsche Bank informed the public that the executive management had learned about possible violations which occurred in past years of the bank's internal procedures or legal requirements in connection with activities involving the bank's corporate security department. Deutsche Bank immediately retained the law firm Cleary Gottlieb Steen. Mandating of external service providers by its corporate security department and their activities. April 2015 Lieber scandal. See also, Lieber scandal. On 23 April 2015, Deutsche Bank agreed to a combined $25 million. Deutsche Bank, the bank's poor oversight of traders, and its failure to take action when it uncovered signs of abuse internally. Role in 2007-2008 financial crisis. The United States Department of Justice is seeking a $14 billion civil settlement with Deutsche Bank over its alleged role in artificially propping up the U.S. housing market in the lead up to the financial crisis of 2007-08 and the Great Recession. Sanctions violations. On 5 November 2015, Deutsche Bank was ordered to pay $258 million, €2,372 million in penalties imposed by the New York State Department of Financial Services and the United States Federal Reserve Bank after the bank was caught doing business with Burma, Libya, Sudan, Iran, and Syria, which were under U.S. sanctions at the time. According to the U.S. federal authorities, Deutsche Bank handled 27,200 U.S. dollar clearing transactions valued at more than $1,086 billion. €998 billion to help evade U.S. sanctions between early 1999 until 2006, which are done on behalf of Iranian, Libyan, Syrian, Burmese, and Sudanese financial institutions and other entities subject to U.S. sanctions, including entities on the specially designated nationals by the Office of Foreign Assets Control. In response to the penalties, the bank will pay US$200 million, €184 million, to the NYDFS, while the rest US$58 million, €533 million, will go to the Federal Reserve. In addition to the payment, the bank will install an independent monitor, fire 6 employees who were involved in the incident, and ban 3 other employees from any work involving the bank's U.S.-based operations. The bank is still under investigation by the U.S. Justice Department and NYDFS into possible sanctions violations relating to the 2014-15 Ukrainian crisis and its activities within Russia Acquisitions Morgan, Grenfell. Purchased by Deutsche Bank for €709 million in 2010. Sal Oppenheim, 2010. Deutsche Postbank, 2010. Notable current and former employees: Hermann Joseph Abs, Chairman 1957-1968; Joseph Ackerman, former CEO 2002-2012; Michael Kars, Head of Global Banking 2002-2010; Sir John Craven, Financier in London; Alfred Herrhausen, Chairman 1988-1989; Anshu Jain, Head of Corporate and Investment Banking; Carl Kimmich, Chairman 1942-1945; Greg Lippmann, Trader; Georg von Siemens, Co-founder and Director 1870-1900; Ted Virtue, Executive Board Member; Herman Wallach, Co-founder and Director 1870-1893; Boaz Weinstein, Derivatives Trader; Public Service; Saji Javed, former Board Member of Deutsche Bank International Limited 2007-2009. Otto Hermann Kahn, Philanthropist Awards Best Banking Performer, Germany in 2016 by Global Brands Magazine Award. See also Companies Portal, European Financial Services Roundtable, Deutsche Bank Prize in Financial Economics. References: Carat New CEO for Deutsche Bank, Carat ABCDE, Deutsche Bank Annual Report 2015, Deutsche Bank the 11th of March 2016, retrieved the 1st of April 2016. Carat STOXX, STOXX Digital, STOXX announces component changes to STOXX Europe 50 Index. www.stoxcom, retrieved 16 August 2016.